Your freedom and privacy on the internet and in everyday life is under attack. You might not even know it. Centralization is increasing, with more and more servers ending up in huge data centers owned by just a handful of corporations. When services and servers get centralized, it threatens the stability and trust of that network. What happens if these businesses one day face regulatory problems, or if a country where one of their data centers are running come under the control of a totalitarian regime or government? Will you be able to trust them to keep services running? Can you trust them to keep your data safe? What if their services or data centers get compromised? They might unintentionally leak your private data without even realizing. Not to mention the amount of malware and spyware is increasing every year. How do you know they aren't infected? There is also the very real threat of intentional monitoring and theft of data from the provider. Can you trust businesses whose sole purpose is monetary gain? It gets worse the longer you look. Personal data that governments store, such as healthcare data, medical records, criminal records, are, at an increasing rate, being stored offshore in major data centers. Not only is your data more vulnerable, but those services become easier to disrupt. Picture this. Every week, Joe visits his local psychiatrist, Jane. He tells her his most cherished and private thoughts, topics that should be confidential between him and Jane. Jane meticulously stores her patient records via an external provider that provides a journaling system for health centers. What Jane doesn't know is that the data is stored on an unencrypted server in a huge data center in the US via another provider. If there's a breach or data leak of any kind with the server provider, all of Joe's patient records risk being leaked onto the internet, along with every other patient that Jane has met. Furthermore, the server provider has insufficient backups, so if something was to happen to the server, Jane would lose all her patient records permanently. This perfectly describes the problem we are facing. Not only are people and governments unaware of how deep the problem runs, they trust the providers to do a good job and keep their data safe. Unfortunately, there are just too many points of failure. This is one of the reasons why the UNIGRID Foundation was started. Like everyone else, we also want to be safe on the internet and in our everyday social life. We shouldn't have to worry that everything about us will be leaked by a third or even fourth party just because we use their service. With UNIGRID, providers don't have to implement and add encryption and security on their own. Instead, the UNIGRID network automates this process, encrypting, securing, and sharding data and services in a fault-tolerant and redundant way. Rather than relying on separate businesses, the internet becomes a global service where everybody can participate and store data.